Sharing folders is a great way to give people access to information, but sometimes it can be a little confusing. Different options, different tools. I'm going to simplify it all for you coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, entertainer here at IT Pro TV, coming back at you with another discussion about how you can optimize your Windows Server experience. In this particular conversation, I'm going to take a look at something so simple, people often overlook it and take it for granted, and they get confused about how to make it happen. I'm talking about how to share folders and files with people, but to do so in an easy way. Now, we're going to be able to take a look at how to do this across three different server operating systems because it works the same in all of them. Take a look at Server 2016, Server 2019, and of course, the brand new Server 2022. I'm going to use Windows Server 2019 running as a virtual machine to show you how to do this and show you just how simple it can be to share that folder out, give people access to it, and make sure they get the information they need when they need it. Join me here. We're going to start out on our server desktop. I'm running Server 2019 in a virtual machine. And remember, no matter what I show you here, it's going to be the same, look the same, be in the same place and work the same way on Server 16 as well as Server 2022. We're going to go down to our Start menu just so we can see how to get access to a folder or create one if we need to. I'm going to show you two ways to do that. We can use the traditional folder icon right here, the File Explorer, and you guys probably know the shortcut for that. Windows key letter E will open that as well. And so we can easily do that, but did you know we could also right-click on that Start menu, and we can go right there to File Explorer to open the same exact item. Always more than one way. As a matter of fact, a minimum of three ways always to do just about anything in Windows, and if you look hard enough, you could probably find more than three. So however you want to open the File Explorer, totally up to you. Since we're here, I'm just going to use my shortcut from our Start menu. It's going to open up. Looks like a standard File Explorer, really going to be the same on every machine. And what we're going to do is simply go into the C drive because I need a folder to work with. Now, I've already created one, but I put it at the root of the C drive. So go take a look for it. You could browse through any of the drives and any of the areas of your system to be able to find the folder that you want to share. It's really up to you. So I'm going to go to the C drive, going to click, bring that up. And I've already created a folder that we're going to use. It is right there. It's called share_me. All I did was right-click new folder to create that. And you can easily do that with no trouble. Or somebody else might be doing this on their system and you're going to be given access to it. But you'll see right here, new folder, and just give it a name and we're able to get that folder set up. So I've done that already. And there's nothing in the folder, but that doesn't really matter. We don't need content in there to share it. We just need to know the folder's location and be able to right-click and then have the ability to make a good choice from the menu items that we see. So let's back up one level. Let's right-click on the Share Me folder. And when we do that, let's take a look at our menu. So we have several options here. I find as I talk to people about this that most people don't realize that they can use this item right here, Give Access To, as we right-click on the menu, and actually share this folder with any of the named users from that system. You'll see the Adam 2, 3, 4, and 5 users are there, or choose specific people, and we can go get a pick list and simply search for or select the user in question, giving them access to this folder automatically once we click the button to share it, and giving them read permissions. That's going to be the default permission they get, meaning they can see what's in the folder, and they can work with it. So that's going to be good enough for most people. So we could do this. This is the first of a couple of different ways, actually three overall that I'm going to show you, that we can share the folder. Let's see what this looks like when we do this. If I go ahead and I choose, and I'm going to choose the Adam 3 user to be able to give access to. If I choose that Adam 3 user, I get this prompt right here. Let's just bring this over here and get it out of the way so we can clearly see it, and I'll zoom in. You'll see it says, hey, do you want to share the selected item or items? All I have to do is click yes, and Windows requires your permission. If not, click no. So I could opt out easily. And notice by default, yes is already highlighted, anticipating that I'm going to click it. But when I click yes, share this item or share the items, boom, it's done. So right click, right? And then choose the user, and then yes, three clicks. And if we include getting to the actual folder, let's say maybe four or five clicks, and I was able to share that folder. And that's all I have to do. Folder is now available. It's shared, but it's shared specifically to that particular user. So that's the first way we can do this. Now, what if I want to do something else? Well, right click again, instead of give access to, let's go down here to the bottom of this menu. And let's just zoom in so you can see that. We're going to go to properties. This is where most of you are probably used to going to make a folder and share it. We go to properties, and on the properties or in the properties area of this particular folder, we'll just zoom in so you could see that. You'll see we have a tabbed interface, and moving left to right from general, we're going to go to sharing. That's going to be the second place that we can go. We're going to see two methods there. So let's take a look. Go to sharing, and under sharing, we'll see that we have both the ability to do what's called standard sharing. That's the item at the top there where it says network file and folder sharing, or what's called advanced sharing. And we'll take a look at each in turn and set up shares using both. Difference here mainly is that when we do advanced sharing, we have more options than we do when we just simply create a normal standard share. So let's take a look. We'll click share, and you'll notice here that we're going to see, we'll just bring this over so you could see that we're kind of stacking those windows up as we go. We could see the users that are already going to have access to this folder and it is shared with Adam 3, the user we just shared with read permission, the administrative user, as well as the administrator's group. I created the folder, so I'm the user as well as a member of the administrator's group, and that group is now the owner. And we can see the permission level, and I have the ability to change that if I want to modify that. Maybe I want to give Adam 3 more permissions, read and write. I could do that right from here before I create the new share or share it with additional people. But let's assume we're going to leave that alone for the minute. I just have to start typing in the name of a user right there in that line where my cursor is. And once I find that user, simply use the add button when I select them to add them to the list. So let's start typing because I'm going to have multiple Adam users there. And I know we have Adam 4. And I'm just going to zoom out so you can see this while I'm doing this. And I can pull down as I start typing. And you'll see I've got a list of all the users currently in the system. Notice I even have an option to create a brand new user right from here on the fly if I want to. So I'm going to choose the Adam 4 user. Click add. They get added to the list immediately. And they have the standard permission of read, just like they would have if we chose the get access to option or give access to option that we just demonstrated. But as I suggested, I can go ahead and I can modify those permissions by clicking on the caret, the downward facing black arrow to the right of read, and selecting read write. Or if I say, you know what, I made a mistake, I don't really want that user there after all, I can simply remove them right from here. So let's change the permissions for Adam 4. Let's go into Adam 2 and let's remove that user while we're here, pulling them off that list so you could see that that's done as well. And sure enough, they're gone. We've modified the permissions for Adam 4. Everybody else is left intact. And we'll click share to finalize our options here and make sure that we can see that, yes, indeed, we did create the share. It has been shared. It says, hey, we can email someone, send them a link, copy the link, give it to them in a variety of ways, no problem. And I even have an option there to see all of the network shares that are on this computer and available. So we can actually go in and click there if we want to see those shares. We'll be taken just to another area inside the Windows File Explorer to the network area. We can see the shares that are published. And sure enough, there are three shares. And one of them, the one in the middle, right there, is going to be the share we just created, the Share Me folder. And we can click, and sure enough, there's nothing in there. But as the administrator, you'll see if I want to, I can create, oh, let's just create a brand new text document. Let's call it hello world.txt or hello.org. Let's rename that so it's actually going to be called something proper. Hello world.txt. Okay. And so now we can see we've created a file inside of that directory. We'll click done. We'll click close. We can go in, and sure enough, I was able to do that directly through the share because I have permissions. No problem. What we say, easy peasy, I think is what people say, right? Last way to do this, let's right click on here. Let's go over to our C drive. I'm going to take you back to the same place, show you the same thing, but show it to you from a different area. And remember, we were on the sharing area, and I said, hey, we could share. We could also do advanced sharing. We could do this on the entire hard drive. We could do it on a single folder. You can do it all sorts of places. It all works the same. It's just a matter of what information you actually want to share and just knowing where that information is. If we go back to the folder, we right click And we go back to sharing for the Share Me folder. And we click Advanced Sharing, like we were about to do. You'll see we can share this folder, specify the name, add another share if we choose to, and or you'll see we could specify permissions. Let's just take a look at some of these options. You'll see we have that. We can go ahead and add a new share, so we can share it as something else if I don't want to call it Share Me. Maybe I want to call this Adam Share 1. I can do that, specify the maximum allowed number of users and or specify a certain number, meaning the maximum allowed under Windows or only, let's say, maybe 10 or something like that. And then I can click permissions and I can specify which users or groups are going to have permissions. By default, everyone has read. It's a wide system group that allows anybody connecting to the computer to interact with the folder. Maybe I want to add a certain user. I can go right over here, maybe one of my Atom users, and I can click add right from there. Let's do that. I just have to know the name of the user and go search for them or browse. So I'll start typing Adam, and let's check the names. I'm going to have to see. I think there's an Adam 5 in there. Let's see if that user comes back. Sure enough, we see the Adam 5 user is available, so we can add that user in. We'll click OK. And then I can specify by highlighting them what level of permission I would like to give. Notice I have different permissions than just read or read write. What I got with the standard share, I can see read, change, or full control. So advanced sharing gives us more permissions, more fine or granular control to create the share and allow users to interact with it. I'm going to specify that we'll give that user read and change. We'll click apply, click OK, we'll click OK. And although we don't see it listed here, we've already created the share and we can tell because now the share name has changed. We do have our user added. When we click permissions, we could see that if we wanted to, but we know they're there. We'll click apply, we'll click OK, we'll click close. And we now have shared that as an additional share, assigning a different user. Now, if you remember, we can go check all the shares that we've created just by coming down here, going to network. So let's do that. Let's go to our machine and let's open that up. And as soon as we do, give it just a second, it'll bring up that list of shares that we were looking at. And we can see that we now have, I guess it'll be a fourth share because we had three already. We'll be able to see our fourth share, the Atom share that we just created. Atom Share 1 specifically is what we created. And it does take a moment sometimes when you're browsing to look for the shares on the computer. It's kind of an archaic way going through the network to find them this way. You normally would go through either a command line, maybe use the netshare command to see what shares are listed, or we could use a browser and go directly to the machine. But we're kind of profiling the machine and asking it to give us information, and we have to be patient with it while it looks it up and thinks and says, oh, this is what you want to see, and it presents it. Oh, let's see. Hold on one second. Not going to let us in. No big deal. All right, well, you know the shares are there. It may just be thinking about showing them to us, but it's not a big deal. What we can do, actually, if you want to see them, just real quick to finish up, we've done this in several different ways. We can go to the server manager and look at the shares right from here. We'll go to the tools menu, and we'll go to our computer management tool, and we'll see the shares that are listed there. And we can tell for sure the share has been created this way. What we're going to do is come over here, go to shared folders right there. We'll go and we'll take a look at shares, and it's going to give us the list, including the most recent share that we just created. Just move this over so we can see that, or at least it should anyway. Let's update that. There it is right there. And Adam Share 1 right at the top alphabetically. You can see the most recent share we created, along with PowerShell, along with ShareMe, users, and some of the dollar sign shares that are administrative in nature. And Windows itself creates and controls. So more, as I said, than one way to find things, usually at least three ways to be able to get to the same information. If one tool decides it's not gonna work for some reason or it's just taking too long, just go use another one, get to the same place, you do the same thing. I'll continue to bring you up-to-date information about how to optimize your Windows Server admin experience in future conversations. But until I come back with another exciting episode, I'm gonna say goodbye for now and wish you happy windowing.